We're TesseracT from the UK. We've just arrived in Lapland, Finland. We're here for the Jägermeister Ice Cold Gig, and we're about to meet our taxi driver who's going to take us right into the wilderness.
Welcome to Lapland.
Thank you.
My name is Janne.
Dan, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Welcome.
Hey.
My name is Janne. Welcome to Lapland. So, I will be your guide, and also I will be your local taxi. So, I will show you the wilderness, and next we can put the helmets on and start our journey.
With Yanni, he took us on the skidoo up across the frozen lake. When I first got here, it feels like another world. It feels alien almost, because I've never seen anything like it, because it is unworldly cold. We're literally in the middle of nowhere, but there's nothing around here. The airport's about an hour's drive. Yeah, it feels pretty remote.
Landing at the airport, seeing this wonderful winterland, it really does hit you in the face and you just suddenly realise exactly where you are. This is the furthest north I've ever been in my life. And I think to be here, we are just extremely lucky. Like, not many people get to do this kind of stuff, and especially as a band, you know, we're brothers at the end of the day, and it draws you together. You feel this really immense sense of spirituality here, and it's powerful stuff.
It's in the middle of nowhere, it's bitterly cold. But we're just surrounded by these gorgeous mountains. Really windy, we can see the wind rolling across the swamp, this frozen swamp, which just looked really eerie, but it was, never seen anything like it, so it was awesome to see.
I mean, everything we do brings us together a little bit more each time. You know, we've known each other for coming on 10 years now. 6 weeks ago, we had no idea that this was going to happen, and it tends to happen. We've got a really strange life, I guess, with these amazing things come out of the blue, all of a sudden you're in Lapland. You know, who does that?
We met Heidi at the reindeer farm. She was a really honest, genuine woman, and it was really nice to see, because in England, you know, everyone's really busy with their life, hustle and bustle, but she was just seemed really relaxed.
How important are the reindeer to the Lapish culture?
Important, yeah. Very, very important, yes. Reindeer herding was most important livelihood in here. It's very important. Younger people are not coming to be a herder anymore, unfortunately. So it's hard work and it's getting harder all the time.
And she invited us into this teepee with a fire. It's nice to relax in there. Had some berry juice and some coffee. Just a really nice, relaxed way of living. Well, that part of it anyway. So yeah, could get used to that part of it.
I would have never thought we'd be up in Lapland about
true.
To play
I suppose
a world's first gig on an igloo.
Yeah.
I mean, it just kind of makes you feel so lucky, doesn't it? Like, yeah. there are not many bands that are ever going to get to do this.
We met Tommy at the frozen river, who's an awesome guy, and he helped us chop up all this ice to take it to the stage, which they used to build the stage with as well. And that was amazing to see this huge frozen river, which they just built the whole place out of.
there's a lot of anticipation building up to seeing the stage, and we're all very eager to see it.
Wow, that is immense.
Oh my god.
This has got to be the most amazing stage ever
to play on.
What an incredible.
Please tell me that you got your drum right.
Oh man.
I mean, that's just amazing, isn't it? I don't think any band ever expects to play in a location like this, let alone on a stage that looks like that in their lives. So we're very lucky guys.
I think sometimes you can't summon up the words to describe how something makes you feel, but actually coming here and walking around the inside of this humongous igloo is just, it's priceless. It's an experience that I never thought I'd get to do. And the amount of effort that's gone into building this place is phenomenal. It's the artwork and the sculptures, the way that it's been all put together is just one big, massive team effort by the guys that live and work here. Lost for words, seeing this stage. It looks like something out of a movie set. You know, I've never been on a movie set, but this just made me think that I was there. You know, it's pristine. It's absolutely amazing. And to think that it was built in 5 days, incredible. It's a very isolated, desolate place, but it's so beautiful at the same time. And it really just makes you reflect on a lot of things, you know, from where we've just come from, leaving that humdrum life and coming out here and seeing the majestic environment. It just really just takes you back. It's very heartwarming. And it is, it lives up to its reputation. It's fantastic. Amazing. It's going to be, without a doubt, the best gig we've ever done in our lives.
And here we are at the Ice Village after an amazing journey through forests along icy tracks on a sled pulled by a snowmobile. Well, the first thing that struck me was the sheer size of the place. I've never seen a structure of ice anything remotely like this. When we walked into the ice bar, it was just had an incredible carving in the middle, amazing furniture made out of big blocks. The intricate detail of all the work is mind-blowing. And then there's a slide made of ice. Can you believe that? You always believe the sky is the limit and anything could be achieved, but I guess never in a million years would I have thought I'd be playing on top of an igloo. Apparently nobody's ever tried anything like this before, so it's amazing to be a part of something so unique and so original, and I guess slightly nerve-wracking because you're playing on top of frozen water with nothing underneath it. That's probably perfectly safe, but it's really exciting.
I think we've got some work to do. We need to hit some local restaurants and bars and start pushing the gig, because we are fairly, you know, in an isolated place, but I'm confident that we're going to get a decent audience.
My name is Daniel. I'm from the UK, and we're here with Jägermeister. I actually sing in a band called TesseracT, and our whole group's here today. Tomorrow we're going to be the world's first band to play a gig on an igloo at the nearby snow village. And we'd love to invite everybody here to come out and support us and have a good night with us. If you'd like to come, we're going to leave some flyers around the bar. And if you could be there for like 8 o'clock and the gig starts at 8:30, we'd love to share the experience with you. It's going to be a world's first, and we're here to have a good time. So please do come along if you feel like you'd like to come and have a good time. Thank you.
Kinda tired of lugging around amps. Amplifiers are the really big blocks that you see at the back of the stage. They're really heavy and they're also fairly unreliable. This replaces an amplifier in its entirety, and it does so much more as well. It's really nice to be able to take some of our production ideas anywhere. I mean, think about where we are. We're in the middle of Lapland, above the Arctic Circle, and we have, in essence, a modern recording studio here. So it's really fantastic for us to be able to do that now. It's a bit less rock and roll, you know. We could have turned up with some amps and just done what we do, but then again, that's not TesseracT.
We all come from different backgrounds. We've had professional careers and jobs, but all of us have had a really strong passion to perform and write music. We're a strong unit and we're great friends. We've been writing music for the last 10 years. We've come a long way and we've been through a lot of struggles, and I think that this is the end of this chapter for TesseracT, and it's the start of a new one. Without a doubt, this is going to be the world's coolest gig. The environment, the lighting setup, all of the ice sculptures, the drum riser, which is about 15 foot in the air, tonight is going to be an absolutely magical time for all of us.
Lost for possession, modern sundowns break me. I like to watch things burn down, soft and gently.
Out of the 7 billion people on the planet, we are but 5 men that are about to do something extraordinary.
Can we see so clear?
amazing, no words, seriously. It's never played anything like that before. I mean, we've played massive stages, you know, festivals, but this is just something completely different.
It was just the most insane, incredible experience that is just going to be really hard to top. It's not every day you get to do something as incredible as this, and getting up there, seeing the crowd of people, all of these little things that you didn't know were on the bucket list that were all of a sudden on the bucket list and ticked off at the same time. So, so amazing. It was great to just look down and see all my buddies playing this insane show to a crowd of people.
It's a once in a lifetime opportunity, but this has to be, this tops everything.
The coolest, the coldest, and the most awesome show. It's certainly the most awesome show we've ever played. It's the most unexpected, superb life experience, and I'll never forget it.